This video is brought to you by CoolStuffInc.com, where you can find cool stuff in stock.
Hello, and welcome back to another day in the arena. Today we're doing a different take on a deck you all know and hate. Maybe love. But before I jump into that, I want to quickly point out that we crossed $7,500 raised for Extra Life Kids, and that means I'm doing a spooky Halloween stream. So if you want to come hang out on Twitch with me for a little while on All Hallows Eve for some spooky themed Magic the Gathering and shenanigans, then please come on out. It will be evil. And for today, what we're going to talk about and play with is Shark Rogues. Yay. Boo. I hear the hate. Let it flow through you. It's interesting how much people have come to hate the rogue decks. As a Dimir mage myself, who's always trying to play cool Dimir control lists, it's always cool when they're terrible. Everybody's like, yeah, that's really cool that you're playing this purple pain Ashiok control. And then as soon as it is actually good, everybody's like, oh, it's annoying. I hate it. So bad. Ugh. Well, I waited a long time for Dimir to come back and have some time in the sun. It wasn't really a good deck for the entirety of the time it was a guild from Guilds of Ravnica. It definitely wasn't good in Dominaria or Ixalan. The last time it was good was in Amonkhet with the Scarab God, so I've waited for this. I'm going to play it sometimes, and yes, I am going to enjoy it. And yes, I do know it is annoying to get dissected by Dimir. This particular take on rogues, I saw it in the MPL, and the one person I remember playing it for sure was Gabriel Nassif, but multiple people came down on this list. Seth Manfield was in a similar position. These are some of the best players in the world, and the best of one version that I've adjusted with, it runs Thieves Guild, Enforcer, and Soaring Thought Thief, but those are the only rogues. So while it is a rogue deck, it is also not the rogue deck you're used to. No crabs, no merfolk wind robbers, no nighthawk scavengers, no Xerath's. A lot of the cards that you're used to are not here because it's actually a sneaky control deck. While Thieves Guild Enforcer and Soaring Thought Thief can attack the opponent and make them miserable, they can also block and defend while you take over the game. And the cards that take over the game, of course, are the best counter slash removal spell in Drown in the Lock, Into the Story with its draw fourness, and the reason we don't play Lurrus in the deck, Shark Typhoon. Shark Typhoon can make those instant speed sharks, of course, and play a complete flash game, but Shark Typhoon can also land on the battlefield. And there are two decks right now that this deck doesn't want to battle very much because it has a tough time with them. Number one is Rakdos because it has Kroxa. Number two is the regular rogue deck because it also has a lot of counter spells and removal for a cycled Shark Typhoon. But if you can resolve the Shark Typhoon hard cast style against Rakdos or the regular rogue deck, they don't have a way to remove it. And that's pretty unique. So the plan against those decks is to get the hard cast Shark Typhoon, whereas against the other decks, it's just a fine way to keep playing your I will not tap out, I will do everything at instant speed game. The other cards that I've added to the deck include one Extinction Event and one Lull Mage's Domination and one Agadeem's Awakening. These one-ofs are fine because you have Salundi Vision, four copies to dig through the deck and find the one that you need, hopefully when you need it. There's also two Blood Chief's Thirsts. Those are not instants, but they are cheap. And there's two Cling to Dust for the Mirror, Life Gain, some things that Dimir normally has trouble with, those graveyard shenanigans we talked about. So it's a control deck. It runs Triomes instead of Temples, so it can play Castle Lochthwain untapped more often. It runs Fable Passage, so it doesn't have too many tap lands. I'm looking forward to seeing how this blue-black, sort of control, sort of attack deck holds up. Some of you are already gagging. To you, I say, let the hate flow through you. Use it. Take your weapon. Strike me down with all of your hatred. And your journey towards the dark side will be complete. Good hand, good hand. Not much to complain about here. Thieves, thief, drown. Will it carry us? Opponent's going to open up on green. We'll open up on black and pass the turn with a very obvious Thieves Guild Enforcer. Everybody's used to this at this point. Trail of Crumbs. All right, it's on. Three mana could be a Skyclave Apparition, which I wouldn't be able to counter anyway. Let's just go all in. Get that mill while we can. Flicker of Fate, huh? Spicy. And there's a wolf. Yep, this looks like the Yorian deck. Double Trail of Crumbs. Are we missing land? This is going to be quick and brutal. Why do people hate this? I don't understand. It's like they never get to resolve a meaningful spell. I'm just gonna go with the more expensive card, because if we draw an untapped land, now we have two counters available instead of one. Which makes it even less likely that the opponent will find a way out of this. Flicker of Fate in the deck is it's a take. It's something you can do. But these Trail of Crumbs are getting punished brutally. Just nasty, because they just couldn't do anything. And you can't spend time against rogues playing cards that don't do anything if you can't deal with the attacks. It's fine. Doesn't save you. Aw, they're being kind of sweet. I'm gonna give them the wah. It is sad. But they played it out. Let's see, they can't sack for food because the visionary is fresh. And lopsided, disgusting game one. That'll make the nerds rage about how much they hate Demure Rogues. Let the rage flow through the comments. Let the comments run red with the blood of our enemies and the tears of the haters. All I've played today is mono red. If this deck loses one more time to mono red, it gets deleted. That's how salty I'm getting. Deleted. Oh, shut up. I'm salty. Don't want to talk to you. Scry to the top so I can ruin it. I'm not a conversationalist. Yeah. Get it off. Get it. Nice scry. Good tome, bro. I'm the worst. I know I'm the worst. A blue-white mage. God knows I love the blue-white, but not today. Today we are rivals. Omen of the Sea. No Yorian. 60 card Yorian? Or just Dream Trawler Machino? Maybe. So I can fetch another blue, Cling to Dust my own graveyard. And then we have triple blue for Lull Mage, but Lull Mage is looking terrible here. What we need is Drown in the Lock. I'm trying to cast this. All right, my graveyard. We want cards in their graveyard. Yeah, that's playable. I was trying to think of what they could ambush me with. Doesn't seem likely. No Omen of the Sea here. It sucks to draw my two one-ofs in the matchup where they're useless. I will say that. A weaker mage would complain about this. Nice. Bye-bye, Kling. Nice to know ya. Opponent just main decks a Soul Guide Lantern in this pile. Got me. Esper it is. Alright. Shark Typhoon. Vision. Vision can get drown. Have some damage. You thinking about making a shark too? It's possible. Okay, going up to 3. I could resolve Vision now, but I don't think Vision will get countered. If it does, I'm pretty happy. 2 to the bottom, alright. We've got a Dancer of the Mancer, you can tell. You can tell. They're just itching to dance on the manse. Scry to the top. Let's see if I can find something to mill you. Too bad I can't find rogues with this sucker. Oof. Opponent in the tank on that. There's the drown. Trying to decide if I wanted to play the Triome. I guess if they Shark Typhoon here, I can drown the creature, but if I do that, then they are open to a dance, which is really bad. Not attacking here gives away that the drown is my only good play. Drown can't stop a dance anyway. And maybe we just steal the shark. I guess that's fine. Omen of the Sun's very annoying. We can counter that. We gotta get him to 7 somehow. Okay, they must have a good card to play because they burned a Mystical Dispute. If it is dance, it's not bad. It's a little bit of value. They definitely got lucky to hit the Kling with the Lantern. That really sucked. Yeah, they get 3 cards out of a dance, so they should do it if they've got it. They're in the tank on the subject. They might fear a Mystical Dispute. It's possible. Make them think about it. Do some card touching. Again, really unfortunate to draw these. Just one ofs. Not for this matchup. Alright, yeah. They did not hold back. And that is a very good dance. Mystical Dispute bluff called. Steal a token? I think not. What can I attack though? Thank you. Opponent messing with me. That's cruel. I already put 1 into the story on the bottom, so we're going to want to sacrifice this. I think they're going to take the Into the Story, but they could take the Vision, knowing that I can't play Into the Story this turn. If they have something that they can resolve that puts them over the top like a shark typhoon, then taking the Vision makes sense. And it's Into the Story. Aggro. Are we going for Yorion? We're going for Shatter. Shatter puts you up to 5. Alright, let's sack this. They play Mystical Dispute. We've got to remember that. We didn't find another end to the story. We found Didn't Say Please, though. I just don't think that this is a shatterable offense. So we'll take this, we'll resolve this, and now I'm going to try to grind it out with the castle. They're going to have the tome. The thief, huh? We don't draw on our turn here. They play Mystical Dispute, so if we play Didn't Say Please, we need mana open to potentially pay for a dispute. Same with Thought Thief. And now the time of the tome has begun. Opponent starting to draw cards with it. We'll see if they have a Heartless Act. That's not bad. Now you're going to say, why didn't I do that first? Again, Mystical Dispute is why. Could have had 2 more cards milled, but I don't think it matters that much. So do we attack with the Enforcer into another Omen of the Sun or a Shark Typhoon? Do we attack with either into a Shark Typhoon? Are we supposed to be aggressive? If they make a large shark, we can steal it. So I think the right play is to attack with the Thought Thief and make them play the shark. Besides, them resolving the Shark Typhoon is the huge risk. Okay, they're digging again. We can't get into a situation where we have to cast Didn't Say Please and we don't have mana for Mystical Dispute. Because I'm pretty sure I know the list. I think it runs 3 Mystical Disputes, 3 Dance of the Mance. Cards like that. 2 to the top. Wish I could mill that. Could try to draw into a rogue, but I think that's too much. That's asking my deck for too much. You put 2 on top. Don't act like you're gonna tome now. I know you're not. Shower the Sky with mana open. Mike Punch because. Alright, you didn't say please. I'm definitely being led into a trap, but I feel like this is the way we have to play this. They have a negate. Wow. Okay. Let's draw with the castle now, because it'll cost us an extra life point after the Thieves Guild Enforcer draws a card. I'm going to start having to make decisions about playing out these cards. Like, the opponent's not going to give me a chance to, and with a castle, it's going to cut off my ability to draw. They're going to scry. I think they're going for another dance. They're definitely going for another dance. Because they kept on top last turn. They drew, and then they scryed instead of saving it to use the mana. So that it's either Yorion or a dance. Both are a problem. Rude. We don't have a choice here. We have to draw into another counter spell now. Because otherwise the opponent just says go. They take the counter next turn. If I had to do that anyway, maybe I should have not used the counter. But it's one less life that I have to pay. Okay. How many negates do you play? And we found another counter. Pretty lucky. Are we still in this game? It's 9-5. That sounds funny. I still think we hold on to Domination because it can take a Yorion. I still think we hold on to Extinction Event because it's good against Dance of the Mance Resolved. Let's give up the Blood Chief's Thirst. I mean, there's so much removal. We could discard a removal spell at random and probably be fine. 4 life for their opponent. Do I care? Not really, right? This isn't the card that's going to beat me. It does make us not play Thought Thief, but we can play into the story. And then we discard a card, they make a 2-2, we can steal the 2-2. It might have Negate or Mystical Dispute, we should play around that and just do nothing here. Three life is low, but that's magic. And that's definitely magic as a control player. They know about this card. We may as well get it out. Does that leave us enough to play Drown in the Lock and pay for a Mystical Dispute? It does. Now we have a threat. Ta-da! The real question now is how many negates they run. I can't really play around that much negating. So I just have to fight it, I guess. Elspeth's Nightmare. God, that's an annoying card, but we can try to end the story into a second counterspell. And the opponent is probably not going to do anything now. They're going to try to wait till next turn, which lets us do this. We didn't find the second counter. We do need to. We could run out the Thought Thief here. I don't think that's very good. I think what we have to prioritize is finding the counter. So we need to start exiling the things that we want our opponent to not have. And I guess Doom Foretold's the best. Oh man. Well, we got the Vision. Vision might find a counterspell out of 21 cards in the deck. Let's have a look. Do we remember what's on the bottom? I really don't. I think there's still an island in the deck, though. So let's play Passage. We've got all these cards. Do we want to discard them, or do we want to run some of this out? The opponent getting back cards like Nightmare is pretty scary. What don't we need for sure, though? Anything? I still like everything. I just need to be able to vision. I might even need to be able to vision into Vision. We can discard the Scatter and the Heartless Act, I think. Besides, having them in the graveyard is fuel for Cling to Dust. Alright. Mm-hmm. So next turn we lose our graveyard. We need to find a way to cling some things very badly. Man, this is a tough game. Dance of the Mance just dismantling us piece by piece, and we're trying to hang in there. So I think we have to make this play. If we do, we can vision into a Drown in the Lock, but not a Didn't Say Please, and still pay for a Dispute. The opponent also knows about these thieves, so it's part of their trap. And I guess there's only one Drown left, but I can't take too much damage. Okay. Could be worse. Is the opponent holding back? I don't know if they're ever going to get a spot to play around vision into counterspell, so I think they should go for it. But that's me. That's CGB talking. It's the opponent's decision. Yep. And they tap out to do it. Alright, let's thin the deck. Have a look really quick. So, Didn't Say Please, Drown in the Lock. And they were near the top, if I'm reading that correctly, or the bottom. It's actually hard to tell. It's gotta be one or the other. Okay. 25 cards in their deck right now, by the way. My graveyard is about to go, so we need to use Cling. Opponent could use their Lantern right now to stop me, but they don't. Do I hold it back because I'm at 2? I don't think the opponent can squeeze out another damage out of nowhere. Deck doesn't really do that. They've played 3 dances. We might be done dancing. I should definitely use the Cling to rebuild. But the question is, should I attack from 1 life? I think this is very likely to die anyway, and I need to draw better cards, so I may as well do this now before bad things happen. Because I lose my graveyard to the Nightmare. Opponent could use the Lantern now and stop me from getting more cards. And oh, they're going to. Okay. So this is the one card I get. And Cling is still in the graveyard, but I don't think that matters very much. And more negates. Alright, this can draw into a card. We'll see if we need that. We'll say go, we'll Heartless Act the 1-1. We'll see if they have their fourth Dance of the Mance here. Alright, let's see if we can draw. I think we still have Thieves Guild Enforcer in the deck. Yeah, 2 of them. Let's see if we can draw one. Fail. I mean, if we get to no cards in hand, it leaves us a draw with a castle. Okay, it's a problem. Our opponent doesn't appear to even be a Yorion deck. Their win cons might be Dance of the Mance, and I see 3 of them in the graveyard, and I see no creatures. Omen of the Sun is something we have to watch out for. I don't know if we can play around it. That's a draw. That is a draw. How many omens? 1. And then there's another on the battlefield. Can we be aggressive here? I don't want to make the shark and block because the opponent can wrath it away. Right now, the Shark Typhoon is a 10. So with a spell, that's lethal next turn. Oh my goodness. But an Omen of the Sun. We might draw into another Typhoon, actually. How many Typhoons are left? There's still two more Typhoons. It's really good. Alright, I'm going in. Be gutsy. Mystical Dispute and Doom Foretold to the yard. 14 cards in deck, but I don't think that's what it's coming to. Here comes Omen of the Sun. I'm going to lose to the Last Dance of the Mance if they find it. One to the top, no! And they scry again anyway, that's gotta be Dance, right? Because they have a Doom Foretold in there. Oh, I guess I don't lose to the Doom. Yes, I do, because it takes... They get Elspeth's Nightmare, they kill the Thought Thief. Okay, they're going for this. Is that what they kept? Ugin? That goes face. So we have to draw a counter. What do we have left that stops the Ugin? Ugin and Dance of the Mance. Are you freaking kidding me? Alright, so there's one Drown in the Lock. Nothing else does it. There's multiple Shark Typhoons. We could draw a Typhoon into a Typhoon. So this mana is Drown in the Lock. This mana is the other Shark Typhoon. I guess there's two Triumphs, so we should leave three to redraw. Alright. Because we might have to draw into draw into draw. Oh my goodness. We play on. We play on. Down to 8. Shatter. Sure. 7. 2 cards left. Am I going to... I've been so lucky to even be in this game. Am I going to steal it? Thieves Guild Enforcer. Let's go, little buddy. Let's go. Is getting the opponent to 3 worth it? I don't think so. And they're at 10, but I get more mills? But if it's another Shatter, do I have anything left? I still have another Shark Typhoon. There's a few ways this could work in my favor. We hit another Ugin and the last Doom Foretold. Okay, that was... We hit Emiria's Call. Okay. Good play, good play. Good play. There are no creatures in this deck. Oh, that only covers one of the two? Extinction Event? You gotta choose. Still a 2-3. Two life. Land? How did I win that game? I got so lucky. That's content, though. That's content. Alright, we'll keep this. We'll play this tapped. We'll play this untapped. We'll play this tapped. We'll play this untapped. The thing that we give up with this is we don't turn one Thieves Guild. But we can't turn two Thought Thief without topping a land anyway, so I think that's okay. Spikefield Cave. Alright, that's, that might be a problem for our Enforcer. We might want to try to fill the graveyard first so it can't be picked off. This is mono red, they play mono red. Not a blue. We needed that to be a blue. Then we could Thieves Guild. Or, didn't say please, I mean. My bad. But we can hang on to Awakening because we're starting to draw a lot of land. Awakening for 5 might get us back an Enforcer and a Thought Thief. We'll see. We can also Shark Typhoon here, which might actually be a good play. I think we'll just take it. Throwing a 1-1 under the bus to prevent 2 doesn't seem right. Okay, here's that card. Really wish I could have countered it. Opponent has 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Didn't say please gets us to where the Thieves Guild needs to be to trade. So I guess we play this. We can also cycle the Typhoon now. Is that worth it? Maybe it is. We really need a removal spell. And like a 1-1 or a 2-2 shark, that's not very important. Okay, this is getting brutal, but this can be the last black source for this. So we can play the island. Attack with the Thought Thief. And wait for a spell. Yeah, the opponent attacks in. If we block and they do nothing, it's actually a big problem. But they're going to do something, right? No, they actually don't have to at all. So we have to no block this. Because they could just kill the Enforcer. And you see, they're smart. They're letting that go. But I guess after I didn't block, they should have done something. Wow. Okay. Out of there. Now our team is powered up. And we draw the removal spell. Clutch. How do we play it? Do we get aggressive? Or do we try to blow them out in combat? This is 5 damage a turn. Once we drown this thing, it will be 3. And we have a counter. We can go 6-6, potentially win. Or we could trade these off and get them all back. But I don't think we want to do that this turn. I think this turn we want to fight. And then next turn we might hold them back, because we want to play the counter and the removal spell. And then we want to tap out and play this at some point. That's a lot of tokens. Let's not. I could also kill this in response, but still, just better to not. Now the risk here is that they force me to sack this to get blue to play Drown. But I don't think they have it. Whatever the it is that I need to counter here. But we'll see. Oh no! Okay, it's a robber. Could have been a lot worse. Now I wish I had held these back for blocks. Down to 5. Can't survive next turn without help, so these have to block. I definitely should have held them back last turn. We don't want to give away the Awakening, so we'll play this on blue. Say go. This is gonna be rough. There's gonna be a lot of creatures and a castle. But I'll still have 5 life and my 2 dorks and hopefully a card off the top that helps. Let's thin the deck now. Opponent with a Bonecrusher Giant? Why didn't they play that on the Enforcer? Keep their creature. I mean, it's probably enough to win, because there's 2 blocks and then 2 damage. So we can't win. We flooded out. I still think I played it wrong, but I don't think we were meant to win the game. Too many lands. Yeah, when you look at it, how many lands? 1, 2, 3, 4. The only thing I could have done differently is save the Shark Typhoon, but you can't expect to draw that many lands in a row. Yeah, I'm empty-handed. I could have held the land and made the opponent think, but they found lethal. You got it. Frickin' mono red. Frickin' mono red. Losing to them is like a thousand scars on my heart. So now these thieves guilds are just gonna have to do the job. Maybe I'll resolve an into the story for the first time today. That would make me happy. That would cheer me up. We might play this tap next turn. Kind of scary, honestly, to play the black that way. Because if I don't draw another blue, that's one way I could lose this game. But I end up keeping hands that require me to draw a color of mana all the time. That's not that unusual. All right. Beastie City. Gruul. We're going to be wondering if they have red mana up their sleeve. Well, if they put something in the graveyard, we can get them to 7, but I don't think that's going to happen, and they would need 2 cards in the graveyard to get to 8, so we're probably not blocking these 1-1s this turn. The real test here, do they have the land? Of course they do. They run like 28, right? 28 potential. And they played the valley last turn, so here's a mammoth. Here's a backup enforcer. And since they played the mammoth, I don't know. Maybe that means they don't have a Great Henge. We need to play a blue this turn to be potentially on time. And none of these are swamps, so this is a tap land. But this is a bad turn. This turn is not going to achieve anything. Embercleave? Alright. So I think we block with the Enforcer and name Odd with the event. Because it's either Embercleave or it's a Lovestruck Beast. Odd. Odd. Well, at least that worked out a little. We got them to 6 cards in the graveyard. We still need the 7th. And we know they don't have an Embercleave, because that was a good spot to play it. Oh, come on. That's rude. How dare you? How dare you have the perfect cards? And I can't play an untapped land here. Ugh. I think we take out the beast. It's way more threatening. They don't have that many adventure creatures in the deck. They might find them, but the beast, like the brush fire would have turned on the beast here, and we'd take way more damage. We have to do better than that. All right, let's go team. We need to get out of this turn really badly. In case of Embercleave, maybe they drew it. Make them pay more for it. Having 2 mana open or 1 mana open is a big difference. Down to 4. Drown in the lock off the top! Alright. Let's kill this now, in case they draw and play an adventure creature. And hold on to your butts. Whatever good creature they have, we can please. I think we're getting into a better position. Stone Coil. They still run Stone Coil. Last card? I think it's a land. A land would make sense from the way this game has gone. So, we can into the story, or we can hold up Vision and use Vision in response to what they do to find the perfect card, which digs deeper than into the story. Or we might do both if they do nothing. I think the Vision's the smart play. Just to make sure that we give ourselves every chance of finding the counter spell or the removal spell. Alright, they do nothing. Let's go for vision. Counter spells are good. Drown in the Lock is amazing. Play the Thought Thief. Start the clock. Play second Thought Thief? Yeah, because we can vision and drown. Let's turn this game around. You gotta believe, guys. Do you believe? Chat, do you believe? Comments, do you believe? Dojo, do you believe? I need to get... I think Dojo is a good way to keep from saying comments on Twitch and chat on YouTube. They know about this. That's a trap. But I still think I do it. I mean, I can't let that resolve. It's too much value. It goes straight to the dome. All right, they're say go. They have something else? This is why Selendy Vision is good. More drowns, more stories. Really good, by the way. -4. And that's a scoop 'em up. Whew! That's what I'm talking about, baby. Alright, this is a tapped land into a Thought Thief into a bunch of counters. Let's do it. Selendy Isle, sitting in the middle of the river. Awkward. Hey, I'm the rogue, not you. Crickets, crickets, frogs, frogs. What'd you get? A Thought Thief. I don't like that. Don't like that one bit. You gonna cast it? No, they're going to go for Annex. All right, one card in the graveyard. Blood Chief's Thirst, what a top deck. I think we use that here because there aren't enough cards in the graveyard for Drown to be good, but we're working on it. And we don't want the opponent to cast our Thought Thief. We need to draw another black pretty badly though. That is something a Drown can kill. Whoa. Fuhrer of the Bitten. Got bit, man, now I'm mad. All right. Crush my bones? If you do, I've got creatures later. You might want to save it. Hmm. I see. Hold on. Would we rather take three or counter this? The opponent could cleave. This is a big decision. That Bonecrusher Giant's annoying, but Thieves Guild Enforcers can take it, but we need time and we need black mana. This might be the play. Although I do want them to invest 3 mana in this card, and by the time it resolves, the other Drown can kill it, so this is fine. Okay, so this turn I'd prefer that they play their Embercleave, I think. So let's see if they do. Nope. Alright. Up to 4 cards in the graveyard. Here's the Bonecrusher Giant. Black source, but tapped. So this turn, I think, is another Drown in the Lock. Getting them to 6 won't help the Thieves Guild Enforcer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Do I want them to play Embercleave this turn? I wanted them to last turn because I had another removal and I could time walk them twice. This turn, it's possibly their only play. But I would still like them to do it. We still have an extinction event if they resolve another creature, and it can take time. Alright. It definitely makes blocking with Thieve Guild Enforcers bad in the future. Wow. We're getting crushed. Is that card an Embercleave, guys? That's what matters right now. It's the only card I can think of. It's not a land. Could be another Bonecrusher Giant. Possible it could be a Torbran. It's usually an Embercleave, though. Let's play around the cleave. It's a land, which means the card in hand. Let's see. I guess they could activate Castle. It's not clear if this is a cleave, based on the way that priority moves. Well, no cleave. Or at least not from that position. You didn't say please. Uh-oh. Good. Don't have a land. Don't do it. Don't have a land. If they have a land, they can escape that. Oh, it'd be so brutal. They're thinking about it. What are you thinking about? No! Oh my gosh, it was a land the whole time. They slow rolled a land the turn before. I did not expect that. Giga Brain Mono Red. Alright. So do we cling something else trying to draw into the answer, or do we hold this? I think we hold this, try to block. Down to four. We could draw something off a cling if we become desperate, but I think we do need to clock our opponent. So let's play this. Okay. Rogues that hate red. Got it. Noted. They just escaped the other Phoenix. This is so brutal. The fact that we hit two is absolutely brutal. And they have enough to pump one or the other, but we do gain life here. It's gotta be the Ox because it draws cards. But I think now we die. Red that hates rogues, confirmed. Down to three. What can we do? Not much, I don't think. We got played this game, man. So we can flashback cling, but we can't draw into anything that will save us. Nice red rogue-hating technology. Should have saved the extinction event. And we are back for the post-game wrap-up, and if you don't know, well, it says in the corner here, streak number 635. That means it's my 635th day in a row releasing a new video. Woo! Some of y'all might be new around here since I talked about it. So, yeah. Down for the content. This deck, however, I didn't like it as much as the other rogues. I think my final verdict, on this is that I don't think Shark Typhoon is worth it in best of one. I think it's a good best of three card. I think it's a much worse best of one card because you're always making creatures behind rate. I think that removing Luris and focusing main deck slots on Shark Typhoon made the matchup with mono red and other aggro decks worse, which is very unacceptable, I think, the way that the meta currently is. Best of one is always an aggro format, so should you be trimming on cards like Blood Chief's Thirst, Heartless Act for Shark Typhoon? Probably not. Should you be playing more crabs? That's always a tough one. I'm not as into... If you're going to play Lurrus, I think you should play Merfolk Windrobber. I think you should also consider a Call of the Death Dweller. That's a different deck. I actually have not played Lurrus Rogues on the channel. You've all seen it. Some of you are sick of it, but I will probably play it someday because, to be honest, it is my style. I think Selendi Vision is good in this deck. I think once you go up to 16 creatures... Vision becomes unreliable and isn't nearly as good. So if you run 4 Windrobber and 4 Crab, that's probably bad. If you run 4 Windrobber, I think you can still run Vision. And then maybe you can run like 1 Crab. So that the game zone you have it in your opener, it's amazing. And the rest of the time, you're not that likely to draw it when it's not very good. I like Didn't Say Please a lot. Card definitely pulled its weight for me and helped fill the graveyard, and just having a what's called a hard counter that hits universally anything and the opponent can't pay mana like Mystical Dispute to get out of it, that was very useful. Essence Scatter should have been good, but I actually came up against creatureless decks, which I didn't expect. And Essence Scatter is a card that's much worse on the draw, so that's something to think about for best of one. Maybe it's just better to have more Blood Chief's Thirst and Heartless Act than Essence Scatter. And yeah. Not feeling the Shark Typhoon replacement for Lurrus. I would go back to Lurrus, and maybe I'll do that in the future. But the Rogue Core, the absolute core heart of the Rogue deck, is this set of cards right here. Like these 16, finding the right shell around them, figuring out what you want to beat and how you want to beat it. I actually really like adding Vision to the mix, because Vision turns one of your late game Flood Out lands into another Into the Story or Drown in the Lock. And we saw how valuable it was in multiple games. So if I were to take something away from this video, Shark Typhoon in best of one, in Rogues particularly, probably not worth it, but I think Vision should be incorporated into more Rogue decks in best of one. All right, that's my wrap on the show. Thanks for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Please leave me a comment. Let me know if you stayed till the end, because you who stay till the end. Yes, you. You're cool.